How do you feel?
I feel great.
I got some good news for you, Rufus. Your venereal disease has been cured through the power of hypnosis! Ladies and gentlemen, the power of the mind is unfathomable. And if you can just unlock that power, you can cure anything from lupus to illiteracy! Yes! However, the human mind is like a labyrinth. And within that labyrinth, there are many dangers, such as booby traps and David Bowie. However, I have developed a method of showing you the way out of that labyrinth, and that method is hypnosis!
His name's Peter.
All right, and what does that mean?
He's always whining about his job.
Wait, don't tell me. You hate your job, don't you?
Yeah.
Hypnosis! Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm about to demonstrate for you my new technique, which I have perfected, patented, and documented in my new book, I Moved Your Cheese, Deal With It, through hypnosis! Which is on sale for $34.95 plus shipping and handling. Now, what I need from you is total silence. Sit back, close your eyes, relax.
Listen to the sound of my voice and remember all that I say. Because the shore of your sitting there in a beige painted room in a comfortable chair.
Thank you. by 10:35. Peter, where the hell have you been, okay? You didn't come into the office on Saturday. Everyone's talking about it.
Hey, Michael, I'm not staying long. I just came to get my address book. I'm going to go ask that waitress out, and I'm not going to want to lose her number.
You are a deep shit, dude.
Holmberg has been looking everywhere for you.
Where are you? Man?
Sleeping, mostly. Michael, I did nothing for 2 whole days. It was everything that I dreamed could be.
You have got to come up with something better than that, okay? All right? You've got to meet with consultants in life now, all right? Tell them you had a nervous breakdown or something. I think they believe that.
Oh, interviews, right.
Well, don't go like this.
Gus!
Michael, no. I've never felt better in my life.
The next batter up looks like Peter Gibson. Oh, there you are. We were just talking about you. Seems like you've been missing a little work lately.
I wouldn't say I've been missing
He's quick, yeah. Well, why don't you come on in and grab a seat? Yeah. What we're trying to do here is we're trying to get a feel for how people spend their day. So if you would you walk us through a typical day?
Yo!
Ah! Sure.
Yes.
Hey, she gets a lunch, right?
Oh, no.
Well, I'm just going to take her for a walk for her lunch. Customer's always right.
Well, you're not a customer here.
Always right. Thanks.
Awesome. All right, so you're going to get me in really big trouble.
Don't worry about it. Just say you have no idea who I am.
No, seriously, I'm not supposed to be doing this.
Fuck off.
What?
No, it's on your thing. You buzzing?
Oh, God. Yeah. It's a flare. It's a big one. Suspenders. We're actually supposed to wear 15. You know what? It's really stupid, actually.
You get to pick them all out yourself?
Yeah. Although, I didn't. I just went to Spencer's and dropped $30. For this one, that's a hot topic. Can we change the subject? I really like talking about Flair.
Sure.
So, what do you do here?
I work at Innotek.
And what do you do there?
I sit in a cubicle, and I update software for the 2000 switch.
I've heard of that. What is that?
It's keeping us all important. What is this? When they wrote this bank software, they... really not important. I don't like my job, and I'm not gonna go anymore.
Not gonna go?
No.
Well, won't you get fired?
Don't know. But I really don't like it, and I'm not gonna go.
Okay, so you're gonna quit?
No. I'm just gonna kind of stop going.
Oh, okay, and when did you decide all this?
About an hour ago.
About an hour ago, huh? Okay, so are you gonna get a new job?
I don't think I'd like a new job.
Yeah, well, what are you gonna do about money and bills and stuff?
You know, I've never really liked paying bills, so I don't think I'm gonna do that anymore either.
Okay, well, that's a pretty bold plan, Peter. What do you want to do?
What I want to do is take you out to dinner. And then I want to go back to my place and watch Kung Fu. You ever watch Kung Fu?
I love Kung Fu.
Channel 9.
Totally.
You should really come back to my place tonight and watch Kung Fu with me.
I think I will. But can I finish my shift first?
Sure.
Good work, Bob. Yeah, I'll go ahead and have Milton move his things up to the crawl space.
Bukaki, loosely translated as facial bath.
Bill, I want to think of Peter Gibbons. Now, we had the chance to meet this young man, and boy, that's just a straight shooter with upper management written all over him.
Wow. I'm just going to have to go right ahead and disagree with you on that one there, okay? He's been really flaky lately. Been having trouble with his TPS report.
Not doing his homework.
I'll handle this. We feel the problem is it was Peter.
So, what are you saying?
Well, it's that you haven't challenged him enough. You know, really motivated him. There it is.
Well, I'm just not real sure about that right now, okay?
Yeah, Bill, let me ask you a real quick question here. How much time would you say you spend each week dealing with these TPS reports?
Yeah.
Hey guys, check me out. I'm Bill.
Hey,
how are you doing? Hey guys, you check what happened to Tom?
No, what happened?
Oh man, check this exposition out, right? So he's all freaked out about the layoff rumors, right? And apparently he decided to check himself out of the hotel Vita, huh? Get my drift?
Oh!
Is he alright?
Oh, yeah, but check it out. He's in the garage pulling the old car exhaust exit, right? When his wife came home early from work, caught his ass.
Oh, thank God, man.
Yeah, but it checks out, right? As soon as he sees her, he has his turnaround. He decides that he wants to live and shit, and he tries to play it off like it was an accident, man. Yeah. Now, check this wackiness out, right? So he makes out as if he's just driving away, and he dozed off or something, right? He pulls out, right? Totally gets smacked by a drunk driver going 69 down the street, man. Yeah.
Oh. Is he alive? Is he alright?
Oh, yeah, dude. But check your irony meter, right? Half the bones in his body are broken. His car's obliterated, sick dude. But he's getting a settlement check from the drunk guy's insurance company for like 80 million G's, dude. Yeah.
At least that is something.
I know, right? Oh, check it out, man. I almost forgot, man. He's having a barbecue this weekend to celebrate, man. Everyone from the office is invited, dude.
Oh, my God. That's terrible.
Yeah, I know, right? Check it out, man. I'm thinking about taking Cindy. Yeah, you know, the naughty CPA from accounting, man. Things go well. Well, my baloney has a first name. It's O-S-C-A-R. My baloney has a second name, it's M-A-Y-E-R. And if she eats it every day, then if you ask me, well, I'll say,
hey, Bill. What happened? Gotta say, I'm a little worried, Peter.
Oh, you heard about Tom, huh?
Yeah, Peter, that's just terrible.
Cathartic, yes.
I've got some concerns about this weekend's performance, and wanted to know if you were going to go ahead and have those TPS reports for us this afternoon.
Outlook not good.
Yeah. So I suppose you and I should go ahead and have a little talk, okay?
Not now, Lumber. I'm kind of busy here. In fact, I'm going to have to go ahead and ask you to come back another time.
I'm going to have to go ahead and come back again another time.
These are not the droids we're looking for.
Yeah, I've got a meeting with the Bobs in a few minutes, actually.
I wasn't aware of any meeting with them.
Move along! Move along!
Yeah, they call
And then I got a romantic montage about 3.5 after that. Catch you later, big guy.
Right. Peter, I'll just go ahead and ask again later. Come on, let's go get the crawl space ready for Milton.
Wretched hive of scum and villainy.
So, I'm sure you've heard rumors circulating about how we're going to do a little house cleaning with some of the software people.
Well, Bob, you gotta do what you gotta do.
Well, we're gonna be dumping the whole team. Skamowski, Bolton, Naga, and Naga. Naga will work here anymore. All it's useless. We're hypothetically gonna bring in some empty little people and farm the rest out to well, fuck, it doesn't matter.
Standard operating procedure.
Do people know about this yet?
No. Of course not.
Oh, wait a minute, then why are you telling me all
this? Peter, I'd like to put you in a position to have as many as 4 people right underneath you. Working right underneath you.
Big promotion, Pete. What do you think?
So you're going to fire Michael and Samir? And you're going to give me more money?
Uh-huh.
Wow.
Of course, this isn't official yet, but our recommendations carry significant weight upstairs.
Then I guess hypothetically I'd have to say, sure. Guys, look, this has been great, but I have an appointment for some bonding and frolicry. I don't want to be late.
No. Don't let us keep you. And we'll get back to you with something on paper.
At least something, all right.
Yeah. I wonder what's going on up in that crawl space.
Who got an awake or wookie nipple pinchy?
Gangster ass, gangster never runs his fucking mouth, 'cause real gangster ass, gangster.